Hey guys, Riske here, and welcome back to Life is Strange, True Colors. So last we left off, we got to Haven Point in Colorado, and we're in this record store looking for a record that Gabe put on hold, because I think she said his birthday's coming up or something. So anyway, we're just kind of looking around.
I love that this town has their own radio station.
And Steph's back, so that's awesome.
Huh. Colorado digs its alt-rock, I see.
Okay. Where the fuck is that cat toy? Can I go back here? Is it back here? Maybe? Whose drum kit is this? Ah.
Is it wrong that the note makes me want to touch it more?
Honestly, same. So I'm like, when you tell me not to do something, that's all I'm going to want to do.
How do I get a rich Polish clarinetist to buy me things?
Right. Made in Poland in the 1930s, this clarinet belonged to Igor Sobieski, a renowned clarinetist and survivor of World War II. Igor and his family moved to New York in 1947, where he founded Sobies Music, an importer of fine instruments from all over the world. Igor eventually retired to Haven Springs, where his generous donations still fund KRCT, Haven's own independent radio station. Well, that's pretty dope.
Perpetual motion. Looks exhausting.
Agreed. Sometimes I just want to lay there and not do a damn thing.
Gabe and I used to dream about cutting demos all the time as kids. Never got there.
You will.
It's been so long since I've played.
Okay, I guess the cat toy is not in here. The fuck is this cat toy?
Any luck finding that cat toy?
Not yet. So, what's the prediction? What do you think Gabe listens to these days?
I'm guessing he's gotten pretty deep into the acoustic EDM scene.
Isn't that an oxymoron?
Isn't all great music?
Well, deep. Well, there's only one way to find out. Let's see if we can find that cat toy.
Or you could just, you know, look and ask him. That's all I'm saying.
What about the top shelf?
What if it's the original Broadway cast recording of Cats?
At least that'd be ironic.
No toy to be seen.
Okay, let's try that drawer.
Maybe that drawer?
It could be Celine Dion's greatest hits.
You mean the essential Celine Dion?
She is a Canadian treasure. Nothing.
God damn it.
Looks like a toy could live here.
What if he exclusively listens to Smash Mouth? Wait for it. Cover bands.
Ugh. I disown him. Damn.
Okay, well, we're running out of options.
Maybe in the junk box.
Ah. And we have a winner. Good guess. Be safe out there.
If I die a horrible cat-related death, tell Gabe I'm sorry.
All right, move it, bitch.
Who's the superior mammal now?
If I had made that joke around my former roommate, she probably would have had a fucking meltdown.
All right.
And made it all about her.
Good idea.
Thanks.
Fuck that bitch.
Our guy lives in the woods. I'm pretty good at this customer service thing.
Okay, Kings of Leon, Gabe, come on now. No judgment to those who like Kings of Leon, they're just not my favorite. I'm a little disappointed in you, Gabe.
Should've known.
What?
I can see why Gabe fits in so well here.
Free drinks tonight at the Black Lantern to celebrate my sister's arrival. The hell is wrong with you, kid? There most certainly are not. It's too late. It's already been posted on the internet. Getting lit for free. Just try it. Can confirm. Alex is great. Aw, can't confirm how she turned out so well and you turned out so you. It's a nature-nurture thing. That's funny.
Wait. Seriously?
Gabe and I used to listen to records together all the time. We'd forget about the world and rock out for hours.
You gotta tell me what Gabe was like as a kid. Any ammunition you can give me?
Actually, he was a pretty badass older brother. He smoked cigarettes, which at the time I thought was awesome. And he somehow managed to get his first tattoo when he was 12.
Damn. The legend only grows. All right, you're looking at 20 even.
No, no way. I can't believe you're doing this again.
Come on.
Do you have any idea how much time I've put into this? You just... No, dude, I can't come over there. I'm working. It's called a job. Maybe you'd understand if you ever had...
I can watch the boost if you gotta get out of here.
Hey, hold on a sec. Are you serious?
You have a playlist, right? I think I can handle that.
You're a lifesaver. Oh, no bird calls, though. I'll be there. One sec. Organizing a LARP shouldn't be this hard.
Are you okay?
Sorry. I was just a little thrown for a moment. Thanks.
You got it.
Somehow I knew I'd find you in here.
Things went well with Charlotte?
Thanks to your help. I can't wait for you guys to meet. I think you'd be great friends. Speaking of, my two favorite people in my favorite place. What have you guys been up to?
Just looking around. This place is pretty sweet.
Every time I'm in here, it reminds me of you. I'm not surprised you like it. Anyway, I'm glad you two met. Not only is this dude my best friend, he's the best guide to Haven you could ever find.
And this dude hands me the best beers? Hey, by the way, Mac was in here earlier and...
What? Hey, Alex, it's Steph. Sorry I had to run out like a crazy person. Excited to meet you for real at the Lantern tonight. You too. Dope, Dr. Lin. May I stop by your room briefly? Yes. Good luck in this new chapter of your life. Please know that I'm here for you if you need me. This caller has been blocked. You will no longer receive messages from their number. Oh, shit. Who's Chelsea? I'll miss you. Don't let anyone push you around, okay? You're rad as hell. Life has been hard these past few years, but I'm really glad we met. Me too. I guess somebody in the place she was in? Okay, cool.
And, he really wants to talk to you.
He knows where to find me. Anyway, my shift starts in 20. Ready to go? Tag along?
I'll catch up. I got a radio show to host.
Okay, well, everybody seems pretty cool so far. But I know it's not going to stay that way, so I'm like, all right, who are the assholes? Who are the people I'm going to hate? They always show themselves eventually. I mean, they kind of have to. That's part of the plot. But, you know. I like Alex so far, though. She's pretty chill. She's growing on me pretty quick.
I should check in. Do you mind?
No, yeah, of course.
W-
What up, Monster Slayer Thanor?
Hey.
1 week to the LARP. You stoked?
Hell yeah.
Attaboy. No, we gotta talk road trips next. It's a long drive to Denver.
Are we driving with Steph?
We'll see. She's a GM, so she's gotta be in Denver pretty early. What are you doing tonight?
Mom says I'm supposed to stay at the Lantern until she gets off work. But I kinda wanna hang out at home. Is that okay?
Do you, man. But I'm gonna check that homework later tonight, though. Better be done, capiche?
Capiche. Good to meet you.
Yeah, same. See you around. So weird seeing you do the dad thing.
Dad thing? No. No, I'm better than a dad. I'm like dad plus. We trust each other. He tells me stuff he doesn't even tell Char.
Ethan didn't tell Gabe about going to explore the old mine. He trusted me to keep his secret. Should I? Or should I blow his cover?
Oh God, I don't know. I'll keep Ethan's secret. I don't know, this might backfire.
You good?
Yeah, fine. Just thinking about you as the Hobbs to Ethan's Calvin.
Exactly! That's exactly what it's like!
Except you're, you know, dating his mom.
Clearly you haven't read my Calvin and Hobbes fanfiction.
Wow.
What? What do you say we get you settled in?
Turning Calvin's mom into a furry. Oh, that's scary. I don't like that. I don't want to think about that.
So, this is what a mining town looks like. Thought there'd be more guys in overalls running around.
With soot all over their faces?
Exactly. What do they mine here, though?
Used to be silver back in the day.
And now?
Uranium. They blow these big holes in the mountains and sell it off to nuclear power plants.
Oh.
Yeah. We'll actually be able to hear a blast later tonight. It's pretty intense.
Sounds like it.
Look who it is. Jed! Hey, got someone I want you to meet. Alex, this is my buddy Jed.
Buddy hell, will you listen to this horse shit? His boss, he means.
You own the Black Lantern.
For the last 12 years or so. It's good to meet you, Alex. Heard a hell of a lot about you.
Oh?
Only bad stuff. Mostly lies.
Your brother's full of shit. You know that? He just about wet himself waiting for you to get here.
I was excited to see him, too. Guess we're an almost wet-yourself kind of family.
Ha! I like her.
Yeah, she's okay, I guess. We're heading in. You coming?
In a minute. Supposed to meet Eleanor to talk spring festival decorations. He tell you about the festival yet?
Not in detail.
I'll fill you in later. Like, you do not want to get this guy started.
I'm loquacious, goddammit. It's charming. Oh, before you leave, word of warning. Max got that old bug up his ass again.
So I've heard.
Yeah. So, just, you know, eyes open. Anyway, you guys go settle. Alex, pleasure.
I'll mind, Jed. So, spring festival equals mountain prom.
It's a lot cooler than it sounds.
Not possible. I'm picturing some straight up Wicker Man shit.
Oh, you've been before.
I love their relationship. It's so cute. I'm like, is there juicy dirt? Why did they end up in the foster system? And what caused them to be apart? I need to know. There's so much backstory I need to know. I'm like so thirsty for all the backstory right now.
Shit, man. This is all yours?
Don't sound so surprised.
When you said that you had a nice place, I was picturing small but homey.
Well then, welcome to my crib.
Seriously, this is great.
And the best part is, it's actually yours. I'm mostly staying at Charlotte's now.
Bet. Say less.
Gabe, I love it.
Good.
I mean it. I don't know what to say.
You can say thank you. Or maybe you're the best. Or I'm definitely naming my first and third born children Gabriel or Gabriella.
Sure thing. Didn't we already do the whole staring at me thing?
It's just, you look a lot like how I imagined you'd be.
Yeah?
Do I look how you expected?
I honestly didn't expect you to have a beard.
Oh, they didn't tell you? When you move to Colorado, you automatically get an amazing beard, a pretentious knowledge of craft beers, and a Subaru.
Funny. I didn't get any of those things.
Don't worry, I will stop at nothing to get you your very own Colorado welcome kit.
Good, because I actually got you something.
Wait, what?
Surprise.
Wait, is this? This is the album I requested.
I know, I'm good.
I was gonna get this for you.
Well, I got it for you first, so I get the credit.
Feels just like old times.
Oh no. Stop that.
I can't. It's too late.
Oh yeah, go get him, bro.
Lifetime of practice! Your turn.
Fine.
Give me a sec. Yeah! Hey, Mac. Can I help you?
Something's wrong.
I read Riley's phone.
I know you've been meeting with her behind my back.
It's not what you think, Mac.
Oh, good. Because I thought you were fucking my girlfriend!
Dude, I promise, you've got it all wrong.
Tell me why I shouldn't kick your ass right now!
No. No, 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 not here. No, no, not here!
It's not my place, Mac.
You really need to talk to your girlfriend.
I'm talking to you!
I didn't...
It's okay.
Your sister's fucking psycho. You could both go fuck yourselves.
I'm so sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Fuck. Wait, Gabe.
Alex. It's fine. I gotta go stop my shift.
Great.
That escalated quickly. All right, well, on that note, I guess we're gonna go ahead and end this episode here. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share this with your friends, hit the bell so you don't miss an upload, and I'll see you guys next time. But I can't cry.
I'll stay half awake, and I'll guess this.